Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm going to show you how to change your brakes on a riding lawnmower. Some of the linkages are different depending on what you have. Older ones have push, this one pulls. Basically the same concept, but just a little different. So, you're gonna need a half inch socket or wrench, some kind of hammer, a flathead screwdriver, and something with like a hook to get this plastic cover off the wheel. And the flat screwdriver, you have to take this C-clip off to get the wheel off, too. So, this is a Craftsman YS4500. Here's some information here on the brakes. Part number 407133. I got the kit, which is the brakes and the disc. So we are going to start by taking our half inch socket and taking these off. Okay. Well, first you have to take this off, this cotter pin here. You don't have to, but it's a little easier. Make sure your brake is off when you're doing this too. So just take that right now. Okay, so now get that one too. So I'm going to take this one out. Alright, so you just seen one of the brake pads fall out there. What happened was I was using this and I smelled brakes burning. Well, it turned out this linkage stuck forward, keeping the brakes on. So it just burnt them right out. Just gonna take these bolts out for now. And you wanna make sure you don't lose this plate. This plate goes here. In there. I also have some spray grease. Endura Castle Endura heavy duty penetrating grease. We're gonna take this grease here and we're just gonna shoot it in. We're gonna kinda shoot it in there. Just kinda lubricate stuff. Make it on this side. Spray that there. Get it on there good. Alright, so that's that. Set that aside for now. Take our screwdriver. This was rusted on, so you just want to kind of pry on. You just grab it and wiggle it off like that. And the other brake just fell out there. Now it looks like there's a lot left, but I shimmed it up with a couple pieces of rubber till I got new ones, but there wasn't stopping. Like, I would be going full speed and I would hit the brake and take 10-15 feet to stop. So I'm just going to take some more of this grease and kind of spray down there. You might just want to have some kind of rag, you know, handy there. So, let that sit up a bit while we're working on these other parts here. So you want to open up your packaging here, and here's our disc. Probably want to have some. Oops, sorry. Probably want to have some brake cleaner too. I'm just gonna. Put this in there. Alright, so now we're going to stick this back on. But first, you wanna. Get your brakes out. And you can see the difference there. So you want to take this brake, set it in there. Shove it in a bit so it doesn't come out. And match that up. Take your hammer. And just, like I said, you don't need a super big hammer here. I think we're good. Yeah, we're good. Alright, so now that we got that on, we want to go back to our other mechanism, and you want to make sure those two push rods are in there, because they will fall out. You want to get your plate again, drop your plate in there, get your other brake pad, drop that in there. It sits a little leaning, I don't know why, but that's just the way it is. So, we're going to put it back on. Put your 20 feet of Bolton. You don't start it. So your brake pad doesn't fall back out. Okay, so now you want to get your half inch socket or wrench. Just sort of get that one in a bit. Tighten it. You don't want to overly tighten it, tighten it, but you know, just so you don't strip the threads out. Now you want to put this back in. Set it in there, turn it around, go back on here. Hold on. why that's not stretching there. God damn it. Probably because the new brakes on there. Tighten them back up. Put your stuff back on there. Your cotter pin. I can find it. Get your cotter pin if it came out good. Get a new one if it didn't. This one came out good, so we're just gonna stick it back in. Fold your tabbies over. So now we're going to put the wheel back on. Grab your wheel here. Make sure it lines up with the cotter pin thing, and sure it lines up with your keyway. Stick your washer back on. Get your C clip. Line that up with this little keyway hole. There's actually a better way. Get a pliers, crimp it down, put it on, and put that back on. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope this helped you change your brakes on your Craftsman or any other lawn tractor. John Deere is a bit different, so the other ones are basically about the same. It looks complicated, but once you get in there, it's really not, because I thought it was going to be hard, and you know, once I got into doing it and stuff, it wasn't too bad. It was easy, as you saw. So thanks for watching, guys. Comment, rate, subscribe, and look on my channel for more. Look on my channel's playlist for more how-to videos on lawn tractors and all the other kind of stuff.